Gee, Shrek. Well, I'm back at it. I'm out on the trail today again. And you know, every once in a while, look at this little configuration to go through here. It's kind of interesting. Now, when you look out there, you just see a big pile, right? Well, you think, what the hell would that be? Why would anybody even be interested in this area at all? It's really interesting when you're doing the research for this stuff. You come across stuff that just is intriguing. It really is. And I was looking for the cavates, and I was on the way back, and I read about a special place, and I decided I was going to find it. And, you know, there's no marking that it's anything here as far as what it is. So the average person probably would go by here and not even know that this place existed. And it's really a pretty important place as you look at it. It looks somewhat unassuming. It's like a big pile of some type of white material. And that's what most people would figure that this was just maybe some type of volcanic ash. But if I told you that this was the oldest location in the United States for this process in Verde Valley, would you be intrigued with that? Would you be intrigued to know that they found mummified bodies here? Pretty incredible. This site that we're going on has been worked for over 2,000 years. You know, this is pre-Columbian, which is pretty interesting when you think that they were in this area before Columbus landed. And so this has been used for thousands of years. And I didn't even know that it existed. But it was a very, very special place. And so let's take a look at it real quick. Be real careful. There are 14 shafts, vertical shafts that were dug here during its time. Look at that. Is that incredible? This is the oldest known mine in the United States. Is that crazy or what? The oldest known mine in the United States. We're rocking right across it. Is that incredible or not? The Spanish were the first ones that documented this in this area, that there was a salt mine. So they mined salt here 2,000 years ago. Is that incredible or what? And because of this being a valley that was underwater and all the volcanic sediment. Now here's something that's interesting right here. You know, you want to definitely be paying attention because those are shafts. Now they've imploded these shafts, but like most mines, they start to come back open again as water rushes through. Look at this. So they mined this back in the 20s and the 30s as well. So this has been known to be a mining area. Now we're on, I can tell you, a shaft right here. I can tell you we're in the area only because I'm seeing the indentions. You better be very careful of what you're getting into out here. But I would have never dreamed that this place even existed. And the importance of this place, to think that the Spanish were here in the late 1400s, early 1500s, is just incredible, that all these different groups of people, from the ancients to the Spaniards to more modern day people. Wow, look at that. Isn't that incredible? I love old mining equipment. Look how heavy of gaze that is. And look at that, the rivets that, you know, on this piece of equipment. And what a fascinating place, just to think of the history. I mean, they were working these mines. And the miner that they found mummified was from an early era. Tell you, you just don't know in the state of Arizona what you're going to step into. You just don't know what direction. I would never thought, you know how critical this would have been. Now, the ancients would have mined this. And then the value of salt was unbelievable. And so they had an unbelievable commodity to trade to other groups. And this assuming pile really has an incredible amount of history. Now, they shut this down because the purity of this salt mine was not at the level that it needed to be to continue to operate later in the years. But man, what a journey this was. I wonder if people even around here even know what this is. What an incredible place. Just to know the history, that this is the oldest mine in the United States. It's pretty incredible. Verde Valley is really a special place. It really is. You know, they have stuff here that is definitely intriguing. You know, what I really love to think about is the fact that generation after generation, decade after decade, you know, they came here and the value of salt was so incredible that, you know, they worked these mines and they traded all the way to Baja California. Isn't that incredible when you think about it? Think about all the history that's sitting on this mound, this unassuming mound right here. And how incredible that really is. And it's the thing that most people drive right by, never know it existed. The importance of this is one of the most important locations in Verde Valley because of the history that's here. Can you imagine finding a mummified body, you know, of somebody, thousands, 6, 7, 8, you know? I mean, it's amazing to think that people mine this because of that precious commodity that was more important than gold to them. This was the most important thing. I mean, salt was the real deal. And now when they first did it, they did it for human consumption. Now later on, it wasn't used for that. But can you imagine the gold mine they found? And to figure it out, you know, it's pretty incredible. Let's go up on this mound here. You know, to think about the artifacts that they found in these caves, these mines, I should say, it's just mind-boggling. And then if you look, the caves are over in that area. But there was ancients that were all over this area. You know, there's Sedona, and then there's Prescott, and then there's the Verde Valley. And there were so many ancients in this area, they would have all came here. And this would have been a big deal. Man, it'd be more precious than gold ever dreamed about being. There's just something about when you're in these locations that you can hear the picks, and then how in the hell they dug before with sticks, you know? Would have been a tough deal. Wouldn't have been an easy thing being an early miner. Imagine finding artifacts from thousands of years ago. Probably a lot of pottery and stuff, just like the areas that where people were close to this. There's probably a lot of artifacts in people's homes that came out of these places. But you know, at one time, remember, it wasn't that big a deal. Nobody really cared. I mean, now it's a horrendous crime, but at one time, you know, people just what they did. You know, I've told you guys, I remember, like, even in Missouri, everybody had an arrowhead collection. Nobody even thought twice about it. They thought it was kind of cool. But, you know, it seemed to be so abundant that nobody really cared. Now, you know, it's a big deal to find that stuff because all of them have been pilfered. So, you know, I like the new way. Leave it where you found it. You know, that's a lot better way to live in this world today is leave it like you found it. Some man-made structure there. That definitely looks like an area there would have been some type of mining. And it could have been all through this little valley here, depending on where the deposit was. We're going to take a walk through this valley and see what we see. The ground's really funny feeling. Well, that's still sharp. That looks like salt deposits there. Isn't that cool? Isn't that cool? That was the only way to see. One way to see. That's absolutely salt. That is absolutely salt. Wow. At least I'm not gonna run out of sodium while I'm on this hike. That is incredible. Kind of crazy, but kind of incredible. So that's what that is. Pretty incredible. I thought it was. You could kind of tell. You could smell it. Man, you just never know, right? You just never know what you're in this journey of life. If you don't stop, you're never going to know, man. You're never going to know. So I would have liked to have gone in the mines in the days where that was available. I'd like to know more about the mummy. So we'll have to do a little research for that, about that mummy. And we'll have a lot more information, you know, that I'll have on the website or on the YouTube video. And we'll dig into this a little more. I find it really intriguing. If you'll notice, all of a sudden too, I really start sweating, and I probably needed that salt. But the ground is really funny. But you know, it's one of them places you drive by, and you know, all the ancients in this area were here. Man, this was something to go to battle for, because salt was a big deal. So all of this, look at all that timbering. They got washed down through here. Now that was an incredible piece of, you know, I'm sure animals today, you know, just like salt. Ooh, I just stuck down in, ooh, I just went in some serious mud. Look at that. I got salt all over my shoes. That was no good. That was muddy mess. Look how all this is though. Look at this, that's incredible. Look at that. How cool is that? How cool is that? I wish I wouldn't have got mud all over my, salt all over my boots. Look at that. But look at that. That is unbelievable. So I'll be aware this time that, because this is really soft. Like somebody else followed suit right there. Look at that. Somebody else decided to do the same thing that I did. I'm going to do it again because I'm going to get over there. Oh, went down again. Look at that. Is that not incredible? Look at the size of those beams. Holy smoke. So there's a mine right there. That is unreal. Size of those beams are unreal. Look at that. Is that not incredible or what? Never thought in a million years I'd be getting muddy up here, but I did. Never thought in a million years I'd be getting muddy. Let's get up on this area right here. That structure there is absolutely unreal. Absolutely unreal. Look at that steel spike in the ground right there too. We're not playing up here. You know, the amount of structure, the amount of wood that was in this is absolutely unreal. I mean, this is unreal. You know, how incredible is this place? Look, I'm starting to sweat again. I'm not gonna run out of salt though. That's what's good. I'm not gonna run out of salt. Well, you know, I'm not gonna tell you it was a super exciting place. Look at that piece right there. I mean, that's incredible, just the size of this thing. Size of those beams. You know, I don't even know what that was, whether it be some type of chute or it's got steel going through it as well. So whatever it was supposed to hold up was a lot. And this piping through here, never knew it existed. Never knew this place existed. Got shafts all underneath us. There's an open shaft right there. So definitely be careful when you're out here, but I definitely suggest you stop just to get a taste. See what I'm saying? A taste of this salt. What an incredible journey it was today. Just a nice stop on the way too, which is pretty cool. Well, that's going to do it for today. I want to appreciate everybody that donates on the Tuesday Live. We go live every Tuesday at 7. A lot of people donate there. A lot of people then donate to Patreon. And I appreciate it. It makes this travel, makes the expense of doing this a little less of a burden. And I appreciate it. Without you guys, I couldn't do this. And I appreciate it. I really do. It's been great to get back out. Funny thing about Camp Verde is very few masks. I like that. That was kind of cool. I was like, you know what? They've lived their life. So, adios, my friends. It's time to roll down the road. And if I can get this mud off my shoes, the salt of the earth is definitely here. That's why salt was so important. When they call something the salt of the earth, it meant it was most precious, right? Well, it was most precious here. Jay Schreck, Black Flag Expeditions. It's time to get in the Yoda and roll. And I'll see you guys later. Thanks again. I appreciate you. Have a great day. Be careful. Stay safe. And onward. It's cold, but it's not terrible. The bottom's fairly rocky, so that's not bad. I'm more worried about getting my pack wet than